you get away without congratulating you on your reelection, although you run opposed. You still went through the process. Your name was on the ballot. So what do you hope to do for the next 4 years, Mayor?
Well, I'd like to look towards some consolidation of powers. I mean, you know, in Knox County, we can't even, the city and the county don't even send their property taxes out in the same envelope. I mean, that's ridiculous, Hubert. It's just a duplication of power. And let's be honest, all we're doing is preserving fiefdoms. The reason we have a city and a county government is ridiculous. There's no real reason for it. We need to look at some common ground we could get and start moving towards that and reducing the expenditures of government. We could provide the same services, but there's so much duplication. We could do it in a less burdensome way. So that's something I'm looking forward to working towards. And, of course, keeping our taxes low. We've gone so long without a tax increase in the county. And we're doing an excellent job. Chris Caldwell, my finance team, they do a wonderful job. We have our bond rating is through the roof. We're paying down debt in Knox County. Everything is just really going well. All our retirement plans are working out well. We're in other communities. They're having to keep going back to the well for their stuff. Their defined benefits and all that. Things that have wrecked places like Detroit, Michigan, and have bankrupted them and bankrupted folks in California and across this country. We don't have those problems in Knox County because we've been fiscally wise. And I just want to thank you, Hubert, for letting me come on the air and talk about it.
In closing, let me ask you this, because this is something that I think did not get the attention it deserved. You rescinded the amusement tax.
Yeah, the county's portion. Well, it's going before commission, and I hope that they will do that. It was done years ago, and in preparation for the Thompson Bowling Arena, and we don't have Thompson Bowling. We've got it, but it's been paid for, and the bond's been paid back, and our portion of it or whatever. And that was my understanding of it. And it's a very small portion. I think it's around
about $200,000 or something like that.
$200,000, which is a lot of money, but in the percentage of our $700+ million budget every year, that is a smaller portion, and the university can decide what they want to do, if they want to keep it on, it's their business. But I don't see any need for it anymore, and so we're doing away with our small portion.
Well, I think that's a good thing. So once again, tomorrow from 3 o'clock until 6 at the Knoxville Expo Center at the corner of Merchants Road and Clinton Highway, free back-to-school bash sponsored by Mayor Birch and other merchants, and also next Sunday on the 17th from 1 until 4 at the Ben Ashley State Veterans Home, going to celebrate Mayor's Birch's birthday and bring gifts for the veterans. That could be your gift to Mayor Birch. Is that correct, Mayor Birch?
That is completely correct. Now, I can think of nothing finer than to take care of some of those old veterans who put their life on the line. Many, like my father, lost a whole lot of friends over there. I lost an uncle. My mom lost a brother fighting in the Second World War. I mean, these guys are living history. And it's just a shame that more folks don't go over there and visit with them.
Thank you for your time today, Mayor Birch. We appreciate that. And once again, congratulations on your recent nuptials. We wish you many years of happiness. And
thank
also
you,
on your reelection, look forward to working with you for the next 4 years. So we're going to close out this hour and take you out with a little Life's Highway by Steve Warner. How about that?
All right. I appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
So much.
Have a great day. You are listening to the Hubert Smith Radio Show on 90.3 The Rock. That's going to close out hour number one. And the second hour, we hope to be talking with Lois Symington from the Tennessee Technology Access Center. And more music, more music, more music. The elections are over. Hey, Dave, got our studio back. Stay with us for a second hour of 90.3 The Rock, bringing Knoxville new music first.
City streets, down country roads, like a stream the people flow. There's bread to win and toast to pay on life's highway.